In this video, we are going to find the output voltage of the circuit and determine the minimum value of the load resistance RL, where the output voltage will remain constant while the input voltage VS varies between 12 and 16 volts. The Zener diode 2 is rated for 3.7 volts and is responsible providing a regulated voltage to the base of the transistor Q2 and respectively 3.1 volt to the output terminal. Here is the relationship between VO and the Zener voltage. To begin, we should verify if the Zener diode 2 is on, because if this diode is not getting the minimum bias current 0.8 amp, then it will remain off and we won't have the expected regulated voltage for the output. As you can see here, the collector of the transistor Q1 is providing the current for the Zener diode 2 and base of the transistor Q2. So by finding both IC1 and IB2, we can determine for the watt RL minimum, the current for the Zener diode 2 will be at least 0.8 milliamp. Here is our key equation need to be solved. Note, we are interested to find IB2 max because any resistor at the emitter terminal will directly affect to the base current, and we are looking for minimum value of RL where it lead to the maximum current at the base of Q2. First, we will determine the IC1 by calculating the current flowing through the emitter of transistor Q1. Q1 is a PNP BJT transistor. Here's how we can find this current. We assume the Zener diode 1 is on, therefore its anode and cathode terminals will have a constant voltage as a 7 volts. And then we write a KVL as the following. And the emitter current for transistor Q1 will be 0.8. We know that in BJT transistor, the current at emitter and collector have a following relationships. Here in this example, these two transistors have a different value for their current gains beta. Beta 1 is 70 and beta 2 is 30. So IC1 will be By the way, if you like what you are watching so far, please hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't yet. This will really help the channel to grow and obviously encourage me to continue creating more and better content. Back to the video, and now we are going to find the value of IB2 max when we have the minimum value for the load resistance RL. Let's rewrite this equation again. And we know that the base current has a following relationship with the emitter current. IAE2 is a current flowing through the emitter of the transistor Q2 here. And also IAE2 is equals to where VAE2 max is. So we will put everything in this equation. So if you solve this equation, you will get the following for the RL minimum. The 32 ohm is the minimum value we should pick for the load resistance, where the output voltage can stay at 3.1 volts. This means the maximum output current will be 3.1 volts. And since the RE2 is very large compared to the RL mean, then with a good approximation we will have 96 mA. So this circuit can provide 96 milliamp of current at 3.1 volt regulated voltage. Please note that because of this design configuration, increasing the load resistance won't affect the output voltage. This is because IC1 minus IB2 is the highest current value the Zener diode 2 can get, and that is always within the Zener maximum current threshold, which is 55. milliamp. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. I also have other videos in reviewing power supply and voltage regulator circuits, which I will put the video links and the playlist under the video description.